Greetings, wonderful people, my name is Ivan, and today I want to talk about localization for your indie games. I will show you my horrible and not so bad solutions using my own games as examples. And if you are going to close the video right now, there's one main point I want you to remember from it. Start thinking about localization even before you insert any text into your game. Trying to retrofit something like that in your project when you're halfway done is super painful, just trust me, I've done that. I'll try to keep all of my tips and advice as engine independent as possible, but in examples I will be showing GameMaker Studio code. Now that this has been told, let me show you my first attempt at localization, which is horrible by the way. This is one of the earliest versions of Nary. It is labeled October 2016, but I'm not sure if that's true. This version definitely existed long before I released a huge update where I fixed this issue among dozens of other ones. The way I used to handle languages and text in general in Nary was the following. I drew every single pixel of every single letter by hand. Later on, I made a separate sprite, an alphabet so to speak, with all the letters I have in the game and just copied and pasted them into new menu frames. Then in the game, when any object that was supposed to represent some text was created, a piece of code would check what is the currently chosen language and replace the sprites of buttons. In other words, my game was made out of pictures. This is one of those stupid mistakes that you'll never believe you had done when you look back at them after some time. So, now that I've laughed at my past self, let me move on to the second, much better example. When I started developing Grizzland, I already knew that I would have at least two languages in the game. Thus, I found a tutorial by Sean Spaulding and bent it for my purposes. For some reason, I wasn't smart enough to do exactly as the tutorial said.
Hello, game developers, designers, and cool kids in general, welcome back!
Anyway, the idea is the following. First of all, you store all of the in-game strings in a text file. The way I did it is I have a script which writes all of the game text into an ini file. It would be much better to include the ini file to the game package, but for some reason I didn't know how to do it. And in my case, if you don't rewrite the modified strings to the file, old, incorrect text will never change. Basically, all of my text is stored in the game code instead of the actual file. So, since it's very likely that you are a much smarter person than I am, store and modify your text in the ini file and later just bundle it together with the game files and read the strings from it. Here's an interesting tip for you. If you don't know how to write the text in the ini file, use the command ini write string section name keyframe random text at least once in any part of your code. Thus, you'll have a structure that you can copy and paste many times and insert your own text and key values in it. And in GameMaker, by default, this file is stored in appdata local your game name, which can be accessed by using the run application and typing %appdata% in it. Secondly, you need to somehow read the stored text from your file. The simplest and most convenient script to use would require you to set up a publicly accessible variable with an ini file name that you want to open. The easiest way to do this in GameMaker is to have an initialization room as the first room in your GameMaker project. In this room, you'll run a script called, for example, initializeGame, and here you will initialize all the global variables you need to use in the game. In our case, write something like global var file name equals quote unquote English.ini. The last string in the script would be room go to next, which changes the room to the next one in your resource tree. Normally that would be a menu or splash screen. In game settings, player will be able to change the language, and with a simple switch you will change the variable to an appropriate ini file name. Also, this script must require an argument representing the string key, string name or string ID in other words. Changing the section name can be useful for sorting things in your ini file. If you do so, it will be easier for translators to put pieces together, but you will need to type both the section name and string name every time you want to search for the value of a string. So, it is up to you to make a decision between the two. Last but definitely not least, try to store your text in specific variables in your objects or classes, or to read it only when you create the piece of text you need. Or, in any other way, just minimize the amount of times you call the string reader script, because it eats a lot of your game's performance. Using a profiler, I found out that calling the script every frame to change the text accordingly to NPC state single-handedly took 30% of all the performance used by the game. ideas regarding how this localization method could be improved. Instead of having one ini file to store all the text, actually make multiple ones. Then, store the file name in the global language file variable or the property of some object, instead of holding a meaningless language name in it as I did. This way, in your read-from-file script, instead of ini open filename.ini, write ini open language file. B. Instead of writing the text into a file after each language change, just include the localization file or files to your game package. In GameMaker, just put it into included files folder. This way you or your translators or your players will be able to just change the text in the ini file without you having to manually input everything back into the game code. C. Finally, you can label the strings by names instead of meaningless numbers. For example, label them NPC sword 1, NPC sword 2, greetings 1, etc. This will allow you to understand which string is stored in the variable without having to search for it in the ini file. To recap, 1. Think about localization and how your text boxes will look in different languages, how they will adapt to different screen and letter sizes, and what will happen if the new strings will be longer than you expect. Think how you will import new languages if you find a translator. How will the procedure look like? 2. If you want to localize your game, my approach would be the following. A. Have a file that stores all the text and include it into your game package. Right now I believe that having multiple files for each language respectively is the most rational idea. B. Have a script that returns a string from your text file with a specific key or an ID assigned to it. C. Don't call reading or writing scripts too often because they eat your game's performance. 3. Localize your game. I believe that games are a medium that can be understood by anyone from any culture. Ask your friends, maybe someone knows a foreign language. Experiment and have fun. If this tutorial / tip / example was interesting or helpful to you, please consider leaving a like and subscribing to this channel. And I'll see you in the next video. Farewell.